And is El Parata de Tapas.
Vamos, vamos, vamos!
They're fighting for the last remaining place in my semi-finals. El Parata's 26-year-old head chef Omar, sous chef Adrian, and front of house manager Ricardo put in a hugely impressive performance in my first test. But they're about to find out I've been spying on them.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi, thank you so much for coming.
Pleasure.
I have something to tell you. You've been tested twice. Because after I left, I then sent in my secret diners to make sure it wasn't a freak night. And this is what happened.
El Parata, here we go.
Professional snooper Simon Davis makes his living spotting faults with restaurants' food and service. I told him not to hold back when he visited El Parata.
Mm. It's lovely, actually, that cheese, that Parmesan cheese is really... gets in your mouth and then just keeps going, just keeps delivering.
Now, this will be a real telltale sign. This is octopus with paprika on and then capers.
Very, very, very good.
That's one of the best dishes I've had for some time, actually.
They know what they're doing.
Loves the food. Some of the most exciting food he's ever eaten.
But what about the service?
The waiter put the food down about 11 minutes ago. He hasn't come back at all. Not once. To either see how we're getting on, engage us in conversation. It tells me he doesn't really care. He's just walked by again, didn't say anything to us. I'm not feeling hugely welcome here as a customer at the moment. That may very well be because he doesn't like the cut of my jib, but I've been looking around the other tables and no one's really getting particularly good service.
Good food is nothing without great service. They go hand in glove.
What have we got here? I think that's cod. Well, that's interesting, isn't it? Because they're not olives. They're raisins. There's no peppers. And there's no capers. It's a tray's description this year. So yeah. It says it's with capers and olives, but I see a small amount of sultanas.
We didn't change the menu.
Oh, so you've changed the dish?
Yeah.
But it's the old dish on here?
Yeah.
I'm allergic to those. I can't eat sultanas.
You want me to take away the plate or just
no? I can't. It's been on. If it's been on the plate, I can't. I can't have it. Yeah, we were keen on that one. You can't just offer to take the sultanas off and bring back the plate. Also, bear in mind that now we've been chatting and looking at it and stuff. It's cold now.
Cod on the menu. So with the capers and peppers arrives with raisins. What happened there?
My fault. Not updating the menu.
Not changing the menu?
Just, yeah.
Just, I mean, how uninterested was that waiter? He's like a zombie.
Yeah, I feel quite ashamed when I've seen this sort of attitude in the service.
Guys, I've got a cool, hip, amazing restaurant there. You're sat on something potentially brilliant. And if someone wants to turn up to work and talk like that to customers, get in washing fucking dishes.
I'm going to get a glass of red wine. Which would you advise?
Well, the menu one's quite nice.
No, I'm going to have this one, the Ramsay.
Sure.
Yep, thank you. Just a glass. Mm. Where's my glass of red wine?
That's Facebook. On the computer, checking out his mates, and still, my secret diner's without the wine.
Excuse me. Yeah, I ordered a glass of red wine.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. So I hope I didn't interrupt you.
No.
Okay.
Unbelievable. What kind of impression does that serve to customers when a waiter's sat there on a computer?
I think at just over 40 quid a head for the quality of the food and the ability of the chef, it's good value. Where it suddenly stops being good value is when you have service like the service that we've seen today.
It is such a shame to see fantastic food let down by extremely poor service.
All the hard work, especially these guys put in the kitchen, gone just down the drain by bad attitude and just horrified.
You've got every right to feel let down, but it's not over and done with. You're still very strong in this competition and you need to bounce back.
A lot to do.
There was no problem with the food. It was a problem with the service, so I feel personally responsible for that. So yeah, I just feel, you know, that we fail.
Disappointed. So we need to work together as a team, and we will make sure this doesn't happen ever again.
Both restaurants have been tested to their limits, but things are only going to get tougher. I'm taking the chefs out of their kitchens and pitting them against each other in my flagship restaurant. I've challenged each chef to create one amazing dish for 20 guests.
Really, really excited. One of the biggest days for me in my career.
If we go forward now, it's going to be just a dream, you know, come true.
It really means a lot for a chef to be here. I hope I can deliver on quality as this restaurant deserves.
Let's do it, yeah?
But to win them the last remaining place in the semi-finals, it will have to be the finest dish of their lives.
Big test. 20 guests only, one stunning dish. Make sure that every ounce of passion, excitement, knowledge and experience goes into that plate. And at the end of it, one restaurant is going through the semi-final, one is leaving the competition. Off we go.
Both restaurants will be going all out to win with a classic Spanish ingredient, pork, favoured for its amazing versatility.
Pork's a very tough meat to get right, and when it's overcooked, nothing worse, dry.
Outside, a dining room full of VIPs, all with a passion for Spanish food, will help me judge both dishes tonight, including renowned Spanish sommelier Bruno Marciano and the Spanish ambassador Don Carles Casajuana Epalet. All the front of house teams can do is wait and hope.
An order. El Parada. Four covers, table five. Four pig cheeks.
Yes, chef.
Thank you.
After my secret diner's bombshell, Omar is putting everything on the line tonight with an incredibly complex dish. He's mixing the refined with the rustic. A rich pig's trotter, foie gras and ham on Wellington, served with a sweet fig puree, will sit alongside some of the cheapest cuts of the pig. Slow-braised tongue and cheeks.
They are the ugly cuts of the pork. You need to be very skillful to make the best out of them. But yeah, very confident. I've tasted all the food. I'm very happy with the flavors, the combination of them all together. So hopefully they all like it.
So you really are going all out there. There's a lot going on there.
A lot of going on. The combination, I think it is fantastic in the mouth.
Seriously ambitious. I mean, there's like three dishes on that one plate. He's obsessed with being so quirky. I just hope the sort of balance of that dish comes together and it's not too weighted. On order, four covers, table five, Fino. Four pork cutlets.
Yes, chef.
Come on, guys, please. At least give me an answer. Look, yes, it's not complete. Get out.
In her own kitchen, Neves is a control freak, shouting orders left, right and centre, but today she's like a different person.
I want to hear that communication and a little bit of oomph, please.
I hope her silence doesn't mean she's lost her nerve.
On order, four covers, table one, Fino. Four pork cutlets.
Yes, sir.
Good. Now it's sounding like a professional kitchen. Let's go, yeah?
Today, Neves is sticking to her Basque roots, creating a simple dish packed with authentic flavours. Pork cutlets marinated in sweet paprika, accompanied by a silky smooth cauliflower puree, and broad beans cooked with hamon.
So you're playing to your strengths. You're keeping it exactly what you cook like in Fino.
Simple Spanish, that's what I do.
Four simple things on the plate, but tasting amazing together.
That's what I hope.
Yeah? Yeah. Pork is lovely. Good.
I hope that I got the right one. Thank you.
With Fino, I'm expecting magic. She's kept it simple. It has to be perfect. Every element on there. Four cutlets away. How long? Give me a time.
I'm ready.
Good. Nevertheless, that looks fantastic. Love the colours. Vibrant, shouting summer. Okay, look, again. Beautiful. Absolutely fantastic. You happy with those? Yes. Table two, please, go. Keep it going, guys, yeah? Food's looking amazing. It's incredible. They're just so focused on getting their dishes absolutely spot on. So focused. I mean, that's the most focused I've seen any chef in this competition.
Nevers is lavishing her complete attention on each dish, letting the ingredients speak for themselves.
Nevers?
Yes, sir?
Two pork away. Last table, please, yes? Fantastic. Go, olive oil. Happy?
Yes, yep. Please.
Go, please. Table four.
Thank you
good.
Very much.
Very nice. Well done. Good job.
Thank you.
Table two.
But will my diners be wowed or underwhelmed by the simplicity of her dish?
Beautiful like colors.
The colors,
yeah. Yeah. Nice combination.
Very, very nice flavors. Sweet and
very good. Omar, how long for the first table, please?
3 minutes.
3 minutes? Great.
Omar and Adriana are attempting to elevate the cheapest cuts of pork up to my Michelin standards. Can they really make a silk purse out of a sow's ear?
When we come to the hot plate, we come together, so you've got a bit of, you know, teamwork going on there, yeah? I don't want that food hanging around here too long. When it's cooked like that, I want it out, yes?
To make sure all five elements reach the table piping hot and beautifully succulent, they must pull together.
And I asked second time to come and help him, so he could have four plates. That's obviously work as a team. I want you to get involved, yeah? Okay, just about perfection, that's all. Come on, you've got to wipe all these little plates. I've got the ambassador of Spain out there, guys. Yeah, I want everything done. And that's the tongue there, yeah?
Yes, the tongue.
He's managed to impress my diners with his challenging ingredients once, but can Omar pull it off again?
Good, go please, table one.
Thank
you. Service, please.
Sophisticated. Yes. The flavor, the textures. Actually, I had never tried the tongue before. Quite surprised. Really, really nice.
Service is over.
Okay, good, well done.
Water.
Wow. Before I taste both dishes, I'm keen to find out what my guests thought of them, starting with El Pirata.
Let's talk pork.
The Wellington, the pork trotters and the...
Yeah, pig trotters,
yes, 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 that was extraordinary.
Both are very good, but El Pirata has been more creative in texture, in flavour.
I've never had pig trotter before. It's absolutely delicious. I love pig trotters, but I thought the sort of little wrap could have done with a bit more pig trotter and a bit less pastry. But, you know, delicious, you know, and we're picking at straws.
Will El Pirata be so generous about Fino's dish?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Nice to see you. Talk to me about the pork chop.
Yeah, it was great. I really enjoyed it. The combination of flavours was great. Mm-hmm. I think it was just an outstanding dish, and it was really, really good.
The El Fino dish was a very simple dish, done very, very well. Beautiful.
I prefer the Fino dish. I think it's more simple, but at the end it was better for me. The other one, it was too much.
Tonight, I've witnessed some of the most outstanding food in the competition from two remarkable chefs.
We've tried our best. We've put a lot of passion and knowledge into our preparation.